Okay, so today I want to talk about a really simple but a very useful example of implementing AI within your workflow, which is lead scoring. Lead scoring has been a thing long before AI, and the concept is you have a lead that comes in and you want to score it in order to determine what to do with it. Do you want to allow them to book a call right away? Do you want to just send them to email? Do you want to escalate it to a certain team? Do you want to send a Slack message saying, hey, this is super urgent, let's follow up with them right away? But before AI, you'd have to do it based on structured data. So if a lead indicates a certain budget, you could score based on that budget. With AI, you can also now score on unstructured data, which is the text that somebody types in when they fill out the lead form. This is especially relevant for service firms where they want to know the situation that somebody needs help with. And because each situation is unique, you kind of want to evaluate the lead based on whatever they type in based on the questions asked. So let's jump into a quick example here. I have a simple form for a crisis management PR firm, and they ask a few things. So they ask some structured data. What is the primary nature of your crisis? How urgent? Industry? Revenue? Do you have a management plan in place? And they ask for some unstructured data. So what's the situation? What actually happened? And when I submit, in the background, we're going to use AI to evaluate this lead against some criteria. And a lead score comes out. So a lead score is from 1 to 5, and this lead is scored at 5, which is the highest priority lead. So then based on the score, we can go ahead and route the lead appropriately to the relevant team. There's also an explanation that's included as to why is this score 5 lead. The reason is they have a bunch of revenue, they're in a certain industry that we care about, and the situation is the kind that we really care about. So under the hood, this is using the Chat Completions API, which is the API that powers ChatGPT. Basically, there's just a prompt that we send with the information that they put in, and the output comes out as the lead score and the explanation. So let's take a look at the actual prompt. I don't want to go through the entire prompt in detail, but just some things to point out. We give it some context as to what it is that we do, and then we provide some rules as to, hey, if they say that the budget is high, add a point. And some rules are, we have to do with structured data, and some rules have to do with unstructured data. So they say leads involving data breaches and legal issues add 1 point. The only reason we know that is by interpreting the text that somebody types in. Then we give it some more context, kind of explain the logic for how the math should be done. Then we provided an actual example of the output. So this can be really helpful sometimes to give AI an example of what it is you actually want to receive back. And then we have this placeholder of responses where the actual responses to the questions that the client types in will go. So really simple, we get back a lead score and we get back an explanation. As you might guess, this can also be applied to other use cases. So things like customer service inquiries, you can kind of do the same thing and figure out which team to route somebody to. As with anything with AI, it can make mistakes. It's not gonna be perfect. And so if you implement a system like this, you should have backup processes in place to make sure that even if, for example, a lead is rated as a low tier, somebody can still look at it and make sure to escalate it to a higher tier if AI got something wrong. But this can be a really effective technique to make sure that your sales team is allocating their time in an efficient way as possible. So that's all I have to say on the example of lead scoring. And until next time.